Howdy everyone! Today we are diving into another powerful enterprise feature with Appsmith, the leading open source low-code platform for internal tools. Think about this. Your organization needs to build a customer 360 dashboard, and your enterprise already has thousands of existing users, roles, and groups that you need to bring into Appsmith and use for granular access control and beyond. Manually migrating or integrating this will be a total pain, but thankfully, Appsmith provides single sign-on and SCIM provision to keep both in sync. In this particular case, we'll integrate Appsmith with Microsoft Azure Entra ID using System for Cross-Domain Identity Management, which I call SCIM, allowing you to bring your Active Directory users, roles, and groups directly into Appsmith. Before we jump in, if you haven't already, make sure to check our previous video on setting up single sign-on with Azure Entra ID. That's a prerequisite for today's setup. With that said, let's cover today's agenda. First, we'll enable SCIM provisioning in Appsmith, and second, we'll sync users and roles automatically from Azure into Appsmith. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, here we are in Azure, and let's circle back on the things we already have in place to start setting up SCIM. The first thing I have is an enterprise application, which is already connected via SAML single sign-on to Appsmith. And again, go back to that video and check that out because that's a prerequisite. But at a glance, we have single sign-on set up with SAML. And if I go to my Appsmith instance, to my settings, and then I go to the authentication area, you will see that indeed SAML 2.0 is already integrated, but I don't have any users, I don't have any groups, and I don't have any roles. Although my users in Azure can authenticate to Appsmith with no problem and see applications and even create their own. But until we do, the SCIM provisioning will be able to keep both Azure and Appsmith roles and groups and users in sync. Because as you can see, I'll just have the administrative users. Also in Azure, just for the sake of testing, I have two groups. One is for marketing and the other one is for sales. In your organization, you might have more groups, more users, and more roles. But for the sake of testing, I just have two. And actually for the marketing one, I have three test users that I'm going to be using for validating that everything is working fine. But again, I just wanted to let you know that we have two groups and we'll be able to see those groups afterwards. All right, so there it is. The single sign-on is already integrated and we're ready to start with the provisioning. So let's go back to Appsmith, and under the access control section, you will see provisioning. And there you will find the System for Cross-Domain Identity Management section. Click on configure, and there you will see what the API endpoint is and then how to generate an API key. Let's generate that API key and make sure to keep it on a safe place because you won't be able to retrieve it back anymore. Just this time. All right, so let's copy that and let's go to Azure. Let's find our enterprise application. And once over there, you will see on the left menu, the provisioning section. That's where we have to go to start our provisioning. Thankfully, Appsmith made things very easy for you because we can use the automated provisioning mode from Azure. Instead of doing manual, we can just go and select automatic. And then you will see the admin credentials section. Over there, you will need to put the tenant URL and the secret token. So let me paste the token that I just copied from Appsmith. And now let's go back and copy the API endpoint value. All right, copy that and put it over here. Once there, you will be able to test the connection. All right, let's do that. And Azure is going to test that the connection is fine, that the SCIM provisioning is correctly set up and ready for us to start using it. So that's great. Once we do that, once we test the connection, we will be able to see some of the other settings, which for me, I'm not really going to do any other change. So with that, we can now save. So once we save that, Azure is going to enable us the mapping section. Now the mappings is very simple. It's just a way for Azure to map some of the different fields for each user and group into Appsmith. Okay, so we're gonna tell Azure, hey, I need you to send and keep in sync these values from the groups and from the users to Appsmith when doing the provisioning. So let's first click on the Entra ID users. And you will see down below all of the different attribute mappings that Azure has set up by default. Now, here we're actually going to delete some of those, actually plenty of those, because we just need three and are actually the first three ones on the row. The user principal name, the active, which is a switch value, letting us know if the user is active or not, and the display name. That's it. Anything else we don't really need, because in Appsmith we don't need those data values from users, okay? So let's very easily start deleting all of those, except for the last three ones, or the first three ones that I just explained to you at the top of this table, all right? So there you go. We just have username, display name, and switch. We're ready to do it, all right? Let's click save. Validate that the changes are saved by Azure, and now we can go back to our provisioning section and go to the groups area. Now on the groups area, it's even easier because we just have three by default and we just need two, which is the display name and the members. So this is all that we need in Appsmith to understand about a group. We just need what the name of that group is and which members are part of that group. So do you see this external ID value here? We don't really need that, so let's get rid of that. Let's click delete, and once again, save, click yes, and that is perfect, all right? So it means that in terms of the provisioning, the mappings, the connections, everything is fine and ready for us to start provisioning our users. So when we go back to the landing page of the provisioning section, we will see the option to start provisioning, okay? We're gonna click this, and Azure is going to start syncing all of the users and groups into Appsmith. Before we do that, let's just make sure that we're ready here. Yes, everything is fine. We don't have anything else to do over there. So let's click start provisioning. Now, take into consideration that depending on the amount of users, groups, and roles that you have in your organization, provisioning is probably going to take a lot of time. But you can manage and monitor all of the provisioning logs on Azure to see what is going on. But again, for me, probably it's going to be very quickly because I should have two groups, around five users, and I think I don't have more than two roles. But for your organization, probably you already have a lot of existing users, groups, and probably just make sure that don't feel scared if that process takes a little bit more of time. We should be able to see some information on the provisioning logs. Let's see if we can see. No, nothing yet. Again, this process might take some time. Let's go back to the provisioning page. And there you go. We just got that the first current cycle is completed 100%, and we've got two users. There was an error that we can see that back in a second, but everything should be good. So if we refresh here on the Appsmith side, now we can see that the information in this page changed, and Appsmith is letting us know, yes, the connection is active. 1 minute ago, you got two users and two groups linked to your IDP. So that's amazing, because indeed we just had two groups and two users participating in those groups. Okay, so now if we go to the users section, we're now going to see the default Appsmith administrative user that we got before, and now also Appsmith sales, which is part of the sales group, awesome, and also the Appsmith test, which is part of the marketing group. Again, if I go back to here to Azure and I see, for example, the sales group, I see that indeed the Appsmith sales representative is part of that group. And that's great. That's the same email address that we got here, the same email address that we got here. So it means that they are synced up, and also Appsmith is going to be letting you know that this, by this icon over here, that these users are linked to the IDP via SCIM provisioning. So that's great. Again, go back to the groups, and now we have the two groups, marketing and sales. So it means that the setup is now successfully accomplished. Now we can test it out. Let's test it out. All right, in order to test this out, I'm going to go to my homepage and I'm going to create a new workspace. This workspace, I'm going to call it sales. And if I go to the settings, to the members section, then I'm going to add a role, okay? I can give permissions to a specific workspace, to an application, and to even doing the granular access control by role, by group, or by user. So I'm going to be selecting the sales group, okay? So the sales group will be able to be developers at this specific workspace that I just created, all right? So now, if I go back here and I have an incognito window here to authenticate, so let's click on the Azure Active Directory single sign-on, and now I'm going to use my Appsmith sales representative credentials here to authenticate to my Azure instance. Okay, let me copy my password around here. There you go, paste it in. No, I don't want to stay signed in, that's fine. And now I'm authenticated to Appsmith with my Azure credentials, and I see the sales workspace because I'm part of the sales group. So here I can now create a new application, for example, and I can start bringing my sales information, my databases, my queries and everything, and I'll be able to deploy this application because I was given that permission. And as you can see, if I click on my user account, it is indeed my Appsmith sales representative username and the password that I have on the Azure instance. So that means that we're done. We just completed the whole cycle of integrating, validating, and testing SCIM provisioning in Appsmith with Azure Active Directory. Now that you have seen how easy it is to set up SCIM provisioning in Appsmith to keep all of your Entra ID Azure users to seamlessly access your internal tools while staying in sync, it is time for you to start the free trial of Appsmith Enterprise and unlock secure, customizable dashboards tailored for your team's needs. And don't forget to check our self-hosting guide videos if you're running Appsmith on AWS, Google Cloud, Kubernetes, Azure, DigitalOcean, whatever. We run Appsmith on any platform and servers. So subscribe to our channel for more tutorials on building powerful internal tools with Appsmith. Lastly, if you are looking to a deeper insight into your customer data, check out our website for success cases, templates, and resources on how to build customer data dashboards. Until the next one.